In this video, I'm going to show you live how to transfer Bitcoin from Coinbase to your Bittrex account. Coming up right now. Welcome back, Satoshi Scopers. Alan here. If you're new to this channel and you want to learn more about investing, trading, or anything else related to cryptocurrency, make sure to subscribe and hit that bell so you don't miss anything. So if you have watched my previous video explaining how to buy your first Bitcoin on Coinbase or GDAX with zero fees, I am sure you'd have your first Bitcoin ready to invest in your first altcoin. So now all we have to do is to transfer the Bitcoin over to your Bittrex account, which is what I'm using for this example. This concept also works if you want to transfer from your Coinbase account to another exchange like Binance or even to a cold wallet like the Ledger Nano S. So firstly, we would go to the Coinbase account and we would go to the buy section. And in this example, I would just buy $50. Okay, and then press buy Bitcoin. Confirm buy. Your purchase was successful. So now that we have bought some Bitcoin on Coinbase, it is ready to be transferred to our Bittrex account. So now we can go to Bittrex and you can see their dashboard. Then you would go to the wallet section. And once you are here, I would always recommend to type in the symbol for your coin that you want to transfer. In this case is Bitcoin, which is BTC. So then it reduces the number of wallets that are available for you to click on. This is just my own way of trying to reduce error. So make sure it says BTC and Bitcoin. So now you can see the plus and the minus symbol. And one very important thing to note before you start transferring any cryptos around is to know that Bitcoin or any other crypto cannot be transferred to another coin's wallet. That means, for example, you can't transfer Bitcoin into Ethereum's wallet or some Ethereum back to Bitcoin. Your coin will be lost. So don't do this. Make sure it's Bitcoin to Bitcoin or Ethereum to Ethereum. Now that we got that out of the way, let's do the transfer. So you can see here Bitcoin and all other coins has a plus and a minus symbol. So the plus means deposit and minus means withdrawal. So right now we want to deposit Bitcoin into Bittrex. So we want to press the plus button and it will come up with an address. If you don't have the address yet, just click on generate address and you'll get one generated for you. So what you do is to double click on the address and it will highlight the whole address and you press control C or copy or right click and press copy. But just make sure you get the whole thing from start to finish. And what I always do as a tip is I always make sure the first two letters and the last two letters match. So it's 17DV for this case. So I just press copy and go back to my Coinbase account. Now you go to your account section and where it says BTC wallet, you want to press send and you want to enter this by pasting it. And you should make sure, like I said, that the first two and the last two letters are exactly the same. So 17, same, DV, same. And make sure there's no space at the end. So now the address is fixed and the amount, I want to send max. So this is all that I can send to my Bittrex account. As you can see, it's not the full $50. I've had to pay some fees to Coinbase and also some fees to transfer to Bittrex. In the notes section, you can say whatever you wish. I'll just say Bittrex tutorial and then press continue. And you can see here, Coinbase is not charging you a fee, but there's a minor fee of 76 cents. That's fine. So now you must enter in your two-factor authentication code. And the two-factor authentication is very important to have as this prevents your account from being fully hacked. So if someone, for example, got a hold of your Coinbase account and they logged in and want to transfer your money out, if they don't have your two-factor code, which comes from your phone, then they can't hack you. So it's just like a double safety net. So if they have your hold of your computer but not your phone, then you're okay. So I'll enter in my two-factor authentication code and press confirm. And now you can see the status is pending. But if you want to see more information on where your Bitcoin is at and how much longer it will take, you can click on here and click on the to address. It will take you to this page where you can see here, this is the one and only transaction for this wallet, and it's 0 out of 6 confirmation. So 6 blocks times 10 minutes per block, which gives you 60 minutes or an hour. So this theoretically should be the maximum amount of time for it to verify and complete your transfer. However, for smaller amounts, it should require less number of blocks to confirm. But to find out, you just wait for 1 block to be completed, which is around 10 minutes. Then you can go and check on Bittrex and you just click refresh and come down to pending deposits. You can see here the confirmations, 1 out of 2. So therefore, it's going to take 2 confirmations for this transfer. It's a small amount, so 2 confirmation is enough. Therefore, 20 minutes. So let's give it that time and I'll come back and finish the video. So now that I've waited around 30 minutes, which means it should be finished, let's go and refresh the page just to be sure. And now we go down to the pending deposit section. There's nothing there and it's in the deposit history now. So that means it should be confirmed. And you just go back up to the top and you can see Bitcoin available balance. So it's in there now and you're ready to invest in your first altcoin. So stick around because in the next video, I'm going to use this available balance to buy and sell on Bittrex and explain to you what each type of buy and sells you can do and when would you want to do this. And I'll put the link below as well. So remember what I said to you before. 1, make sure the first 2 letters and the last 2 letters of your Bitcoin wallet address matches from when you copy it to when you paste it, and make sure there's no space either before or after. And secondly, make sure to only transfer cryptocurrencies of the same type. So Bitcoin with Bitcoin or Litecoin with Litecoin, but don't swap them around because you'll lose your coin. So if you want me to do another live example on transferring your Bitcoin to a cold wallet or even another exchange, just let me know in the comment section below. So thanks so much for checking out this video. If you found it valuable today, make sure to hit that like button and let me know. And always remember to follow the sats.